ورفع أبويه على العرش وخروا له سجدا وقال يا أبت هذا تأويل رؤياي من قبل قد جعلها ربي حقا وقد أحسن بي إذ أخرجني من السجن وجاء بكم من البدو من بعد أن نزغ الشيطان بيني وبين إخوتي إن ربي لطيف لما يشاء إنه هو العليم الحكيم.
When a person is oppressed, he or she will feel the hurt, the pain, and the abuse of others. And when this happens to us, we feel the need to share that experience with others, to vent out, or to ask for intervention. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted the oppressed to express themselves. Allah said, لَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهُ الْجَهْرَ بِالسُّوءِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ إِلَّا مَنْ ظُلِمْ. Allah does not like negative thoughts to be voiced out and to be expressed except by those who have been wronged. In the case of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam, we see an example of that. At a moment of glory and victory, when his dream came to manifestation, he felt the need and he started reflecting on the sequence of events that led to this moment. And what is impressive and shows a lot of manners and emotional intelligence and adab is how he expressed his brother's previous oppression. He did not reflect on how they tried to kill me or how they were jealous of me. He did not recall any negative connotation to their plots and jealousy. He blamed it all on the shaitan. He referred to all that, he said, after the devil ignited rivalry between me and my brothers. بيني وبين إخوتي. His excellence Ihsan was manifested one time after the other in his story. And at that moment, he showed extreme adab in referring to his brothers, earlier sins and actions. Many times, those who made a mistake know they have done a mistake. They may not admit it, but deep inside, they do have a nafs al-lawwama, a self-reproaching soul. Many times, you don't even need to add to that voice, but just to awaken it inside them. And sometimes, you need them not to think about that moment of weakness. You want them to move on in life. And that's why our scholars said, ذكر الجفاء في وقت الصفاء من الجفاء. Recalling tensions and disagreements and negative emotions at times of harmony and peace is by itself an act of friction. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the wisdom, the hikmah of Prophet Yusuf alayhi salam through the Quran. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.